for streaming. Okie dokie. So, this week I am drawing Batman, and I haven't a clue what I'm doing. I haven't made any plans, no preparation, no reference. So, I'm flying blind here, but we'll see what happens. Hey, Minsk. Minsk. I never know if I'm saying that right. Okay, so, I'm just gonna roughly... I always kind of do this first, break it into three quarters, roughly, just for two, one composition, but two, also, it's less intimidating, it's not a blank page anymore, if you know what I mean. Oh, good, I'm saying it right. Cool. Hey, Louis. I assume it's Louis, right? Okay, Batman. It's always tough with Batman because everyone's done him. And I've drawn him so many times myself, so... Let's see. Okay, I have an idea. Okay, well, would you prefer Lewis or Louis? I'll try to remember. Alicat, hey. Yeah, I haven't been doing too bad with the old streaming the last while, Alicat. I've been doing it like every Monday for the past month, anyway, roughly. Hey, David. Lewis. Yeah, Lewis, this is a commission piece. I took some commissions for January. If I'm being honest, I was a bit tight on cash. So I took some commissions in January to balance the old books. And I think I took five. And I also was reminded there was some that I owed from before, some friends I promised commissions to that I never really got around to. So I'm kind of back on a book at the moment. And how is that light? Is that too much? Point it away a little. Let's see. Yeah, I'm back on a book. But it's not like deadline crunch time or anything, so I figured I'd take the time to try, one, do some commissions, but two, also maybe catch up on ones that I had promised. So I did a Mission Impossible one last week. That was one I promised a long time ago. This one is one of the newer commissioned ones. And I have about three left. Once those three are done, I'm not sure if I'll stop streaming again for a while. I am enjoying the having something kind of finished every week. That's kind of nice. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll be back in Portsmouth. Yeah, I was asked a long time ago and I said yeah, because I had a really good time last time. Everyone was quite nice. See here, I'm trying to figure out what I'm doing with this exactly. The answer? I'm not sure. Something about this I do not like. I think the composition is a little off. What was I saying? So once this commission slate is full, I don't know, because I have a couple of cons on during the year, so I might just like take them well in advance and just tip away at them. I don't get a whole lot done on a Monday when I am doing these, but like I said, it's a kind of cool way to have something finished each month. Ooh, where am I going to miss, actually? This is a little creepier. Hobby. Hello, heyo, Hobby. How are you doing? Which event is in Portsmouth? I guess Portsmouth Comic Con. I've been and I can't remember what it's called. It's on in May. It's on in early May, I believe. And they have some cool guests already. I think Chris Weston is going. Tommy Lee Edwards, who's an amazing artist. If you guys haven't seen his stuff, I would check it out big time. I'm already planning on getting his sketchbook there. It is on over, the Portsmouth show is on over the Free Humble Day. That is true. Batman. This is totally doing it for me, I have to say. I hope everything's okay in Michigan. hobbies. Yeah, I don't think I'd want to be anywhere near a blizzard. Can't figure out what to do with this hand here. I'll figure it out though. Abicat, it is can be and can't be, because there's some creators who like would do events. On Freaking Olympic Day. So can't go to the show because of it. But it was a lovely weekend last time, I have to say. The sun was out and everything. It was really like really cool again for a show. They have a beer garden out the side, which is where I spent a lot of time. Ah, there we go. That's what you're doing, Javi. Okay, I'm just gonna roll this out again because I don't like too much pencil on the page. Danny Elfman, you don't have a longer version of that Batman theme, do you? There we go. That'll do it. Yeah, Tommy Lee Edwards is fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Tommy Lee Edwards, he hasn't had a comic out in the last few years, but he did 1985 with Mark Miller. Most people remember that. I think that was his last big, big project. He's done lots of stuff. He was on Moon Knight. He was one of my influences on Moon Knight. Oh, I think I know what I'm doing here. It's way better. Louis. What the hell do you want me to call you again? Lewis. And Emerald City in a few weeks. First outside the UK, Tommy's will be the first visit. Is Tommy going to be in Emerald City? That is a great, great, great show. I really wish I was going. Very much so. Get better light on this now since I'm doing better pencils. Like my Batman with big broad shoulders. Do 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 do. Beer garden is basically outside where you can have beer. I don't know where you live, Ali Cat, but we don't have it too often here because the weather's not great. But at this show, there's like a tent out the side where they have a bar, so you can kind of sit out in the sun and enjoy a little bit of alcohol. David, you also did Turf, yes. David's right. Tommy Lee did Turf with Jonathan Ross before. No, after. Sorry, it was after 1985. for Image Comics, and that's a beaut. It's gorgeous. Yeah, David has a good point. If you like Danielle Zezel, I have no idea how to say a second name, or J.P. Leon, yeah, that kind of stuff, which of course is, right up my alley. Sorry, this is kind of a messy drawing, but I took a poll on Twitter, and I should have figured people would pick Batman, but I didn't want to make any presumptions. So that his no, apart from JP, Creature of the Night, JP hasn't done much interiors Minsk. He was doing pretty much covers for the last few years for Dark Horse and DC. He was doing all the massive covers, and covers for what else? DMZ, that's right. But he hadn't done interiors in a while, I don't think. Well, he did a couple of issues of Detective Comics, actually. I would say probably 3 years ago. Colored by Dave Stewart. They were, as the kids say, da bomb. Oh, you're right, actually, definitely. He did some Mother Panic as well. You're right. You're dead right. You know my favorite artist better than I do. Son of a bitch. Actually missed the Mother Panic issues. Actually, Tommy Lee did Mother Panic as well. Sorry. Shows I know what I'm talking about, huh? I'm going to do some light inking on this because it's getting a little messy. I prefer to clean it up. I would recommend you do Minsk, although clearly I have to do the same. I should have done is looked at some JP Leon Batman commissions before I did this. These commissions, especially as Batman ones, always look amazing. Thank you. Black Diamond here. Problem is this pose is so kind of open and bare. I don't want it to be white, you know. So I'm trying to figure out the best way to kind of black it out and push it into the shadow more, without losing it completely. I'll get there. And since Shadow Silent, have I ever worried about missing out on jobs for being honest? I don't mind you asking. Could you give me an example? Because I was honest this week on the old Twitter about companies not paying artists. That was honest. But I wasn't worried about missing out on jobs. Because, well, it wasn't Marvel or DC. I would definitely... Well, definitely. There's sometimes industry stuff is announced, and I might think it's dumb, or I might think it's stupid, or I might think that somebody's been treated unfairly. But I've definitely heard examples of... certain companies holding certain grudges, you know. Stuff some people have said has definitely been used against them, so it's definitely something to be concerned about. I don't think I'm irresponsible in things I say, or at least I try not to be reactionary. But, sorry, you're saying that I talked about a publisher not paying. Yeah, I wasn't worried because the publishers in question I don't really work with. So, I mean, I work with the two biggest publishers, three biggest publishers, Image, DC, and Marvel, of like superhero comics at least. So, I mean, it wasn't an issue with them, so I wasn't worried about them getting upset. If anything, people who worked at those companies were curious as to what I was talking about. No, they're great. Sorry, 1 second. After I have to read an email. Sorry, 1 second. Sorry, I was offered a cover job, so I just said yes. But sorry, as regards speaking out about stuff or being honest, yeah, definitely would be something to be worried about because people can definitely hurt you. But I think it also depends on the type of person you are. Sometimes people will understand that your heart's in the right place. But I wasn't worried this week because, yeah, I wasn't in a position to be hurt. Other people were in a position to be hurt, so I thought it was only right to say something. Which seems to have been the right move, from what I hear. It seems people aren't getting paid, so that's good. Any books on drawing I use this for learning? That's always a tough one because I can never really remember. Boring answer is How to Draw Comics the Marvel Way by Stan Lee and John Buscema. That is pretty invaluable, to be honest. Even though like it's a book from the 70s, it has all the basics, it has all the fundamentals in there. It was great for me when I was learning, like, teaches all about foreshortening, perspective, like figure proportions. Yeah, it's great. I would recommend that one. I'm trying to think of some other good ones that I found helpful. There's a lot of good stuff has come out since, in fairness. I do know the DC Comics Guide to Penciling, Inking, and Colouring, three different books, or the colouring ones, lettering as well, I think. That was a huge help too. Colouring might be a little out of date at this stage, but even for the basics and for the lettering, it's great. Just hit this with a brush. Hobby, am I looking at reference off camera? No, I'm not actually. I'm just doing all this out of my head. Other commissions, I did a Mission Impossible one last week, and I was looking at reference because, you know, it was Tom Cruise, and I don't know how to draw him out of my head. This one though, no, I am doing this out of my head. I'm just making up this building as I go along, and I know how to draw Batman at this stage. At least I'm not going to want to. I mean, for drawing, I would recommend that you do look at reference, but yeah, I've drawn this stuff a few times, so I know I have a fairly good idea what I'm doing. Thank you.
black it out. Let's see how we are.
Any other questions, ask away, guys. I'm not the best at talking and drawing, but at least talking keeps me occupied. Because I don't really be listening to stuff. So if you guys ask me questions, it keeps me company. Which makes this a bit more fun, to be honest. Aside from Buffy, do I also have any other animals? Am I an animal lover in general? Nope, just Buffy. Buffy's all I have. I wouldn't say I'm an animal. I do love animals. I had dogs when I was younger, and I was crazy at them. But it was tough because they kept dying. I lived out in the countryside. Sorry, one second. Getting a call that. I am hanging up on my own mother right now. She will be very annoyed with me. I can't plug this in either. I'll have to call her back later. But yeah, I love dogs, but don't own a dog of my own. That's since I was a kid, because they kept dying, and that really upset me. Because we lived out in a very busy country road, and no matter what, they'd always end up running out onto the road and getting hit by a car. So I think I've always avoided having pets otherwise. But I came back to Ireland after being away for a while, and my girlfriend at the time wanted a pet, so we got Buffy. Yeah, dogs dying sucks. Hobby, what do I do outside of comics? And I'll be honest, not a whole lot. I work a lot of the time, pretty much most of the time. When I'm not drawing comics, I generally tend to try and see friends. So it's generally social occasions, pub, drinks, or I try clear the time to go to conventions and stuff, so I travel a little bit. But in my free time, I generally tend to try like watch movies, TV shows, read comics. Stuff that I don't get a chance to do each day. I'm actively trying to watch more films this year because I'm a big movie buff, but it's just time. Drawing comics is a very, very time consuming job. Yeah, not to make it out like it's a horrible job or anything, it's a great job, it's just, it is very, very time consuming. Thank you. What's a normal work day look like for me? Well, a bit all over the place right now, but let's just presume I'm working at my best, which I am not at the moment. But when I'm doing well, I am up around 9, working by 10, take lunch around 3 for a half hour, back working by 3:30 or 4, take a break around 8 or 9 for dinner, get back up work an hour later, and get to call it a night around 3 o'clock in the morning. That's if I'm doing well. If I don't start as early as I'd like to, which is happening a good bit at the moment, then I'm staying up later to make up for lost time. So I'm trying to get back on a regular schedule now. This is a slippery slope. There's always deadlines, there's always something that else that needs to be done, and I do so many different things. One night I'll be doing layouts, the other night I'll be colouring, the other night I'll be pencilling. Yeah, it's a lot. Favorite movie? I always tend to go with The Shawshank Redemption. Love that film. Also, I would say Winter Soldier is probably nearly there as well. I love that film. Road to Perdition. Goodfellas. Atonement. I don't know if you've ever seen that. That's a film I really love. And always just having one answer to that question is always really, really tough. The Me The One from 2007. James McAvoy, Keira Knightley. Who else is in it? Saoirse Ronan. She's only a bit babby in it. Nerdizzle. Obviously, you're super busy most of the time, but did you play any video games in 2018? I don't play video games, Nerdizzle. Not since I got serious about drawing comics. I used to play Vice City back in the day, back in the olden days. But I did actually play some games near the end of 2018. I played the Spider-Man game. Like, I just had a little bit of a go of it. I didn't like I played like I think I got 11% through it before I got busy again, but I was loving it. It was great. And I play sometimes when I get the chance, I play Star Trek Bridge, I think it's called Bridge Crew. That is, yeah, with some friends, which is where yeah, you're just on a bridge of a Starfleet ship and you're just on adventures with your mates. So, not big games guy, but I definitely play. I played more in this last year than I have in a long, long, long time. I have the odd time played Left 4 Dead as well. No, it's not Left 4 Dead. It's yeah, it is Left 4 Dead. Yeah, the zombie-ish thing. With a friend of mine. I haven't played it in a long, long, long time, but I did enjoy it. But video games are such a time suck. They eat up so much time. It's really hard to justify that. For me, at least. Oh yeah, I definitely did try Spidey. God, it was class. I mean, I used to play the old Spider-Man 2 game on the Xbox, and I loved that. That was like to me amazing. So it was nice to come back to a video game that was like that, but so much better. Like I honestly didn't give a shit about the game. I just love web slinging around the place. I'll try to get through this a little bit faster. Otherwise, my mom will murder me. No, thanks for the response. This is fantastic. Gotta head to class. Can't wait to see the finished product. Thanks, Nerdizzle. Cheers. Thanks for tuning in, I guess. That's what you're doing, right? Tuning in. Best luck with class. somebody's asking what I do my free time. Actually, I should have answered that. I also tend to like play some Star Trek video games or board games with their friends. Whatever gets me out of the house, really. I'll be around working from a studio or at home. Both. I have a home studio basically. I rent like basically a 3-bedroom place where I have a room and I live with 2 other people who share a room, and we all share a studio space, which is pretty decent size. Like, so the 3 of us work here really. Really comfortably. I've only ever really once had a studio outside of home when I lived in Scotland. Or I'd actually lived in a wholly other building, in the neighborhood, and would go to, say, quote unquote, work each day. Well, it was work. But I pretty much had a home studio for the past 8 years, I guess. Which suits me fine. Oh, so your hobby says I'm similar to two bedroom place with a studio in the extra room. So you're living on your own, hobby? What do you work on in your studio? Oh, cool. I'm doing full-time design, comics, some freelance stuff in the free time, and you're with your fiance. That sounds pretty cool. Another question. What area of my art would I like to see grow in the next year? What do you see as needing improvement? Good question. Coloring is a thing that I'm really trying to work on at the moment. I pretty much worked with one colorist for a long time, but this year I'm trying to like it's always kind of a bit of a blind spot for me. And I didn't like not being able to do something. And I was quite scared about it, so I've been pushing myself to color more this year, and it's actually going pretty well. I've kind of pretty much told Marvel if I do a cover, I'm going to color it myself, and they've been okay with it. So I don't know if you see my stuff on Twitter, but I do covers for Dead Man Logan at Marvel, and I've been coloring those books, which are kind of a, they have like a very, very limited palette. It's essentially three, a variation of three colors. So I've been kind of like just kind of getting comfortable doing those, and meanwhile trying to push things on other covers. Like I just did a cover and did a cover today that I'm really, really happy with. Not to say that I can't get better at drawing or anything. I always can, but I have a fairly good handle on drawing, and I just kind of feel like the coloring would be the next step to really try and develop fully formed illustration. Anything else I can kind of work on as part of it all. I've also been trying to look at some production design as well. Just did some, just did the design and logo for the graphic novel I'm writing. So that's something I also have been kind of scared about. So I wanted to kind of try give myself that challenge. But it's, you know, it's drips and drabs, tipping away. It's not something I'm going to be good at straight away. So I'm just trying to find excuses to give myself opportunities to experiment. You know, when I'm doing this as long as I have been, and like I don't know how to do certain things, kind of annoys me. I'm like, I should be able to do all this stuff. So I'm trying to really cover my bases now. Just looked at the cover and it looks good. Those colors aren't easy to use either. Yeah, it's pretty limited, but I think I find what I'm essentially, I'm fairly good with knowing what I'm thinking, but I lack the technical expertise to pull it all off. So with those covers, I'm kind of like giving myself a challenge each month, and then trying to meet up a challenge. So, you know, one week it might be that I'm trying to like use a brush more, using Photoshop brushes more, or the next one might be I'm trying to like get better at rendering, or the next one might be I'm trying to use like gradients, or I just give myself little challenges that way. So because colors are limited, it's essentially I find that restrictions can be good, to push you to innovate. I find a lot of time when the, like when you have lots and lots and lots of options, like well, especially me, especially with colouring, I know that lots of options paralyse me a little because I don't know what to do. But by having very limited options, it means it forces me to just make a decision, and that's worked well so far. Javi says, in my colouring experience, red is tricky. It's so impactful and easy to fuck up. Well, I love red and I love limited use of red. My Neanderthal brain really responds to it. But I think the browns are what's harder because it really plays with values. I mean, anyone can stick in like a sexy red and it looks cool, but it's actually true. The challenge is trying to balance those dull browns, because they can be pretty boring if you're not careful. This isn't too far from being done, actually. I think essentially needs another tone, just a darker tone. I have this right here, I believe. So yeah, I'm just doing a darker tone on a lot of this to push some of those shadows. Thank you. Oh, thanks, Hesperus. Cheers. Men's, why do I do comics? As in, what makes it the more special other forms of art to you? Geez, that's a big question. I just fell in love with it at an early age. I was drawing comics before I knew what comics were. I was watching cartoons and then I was drawing my own little adventures of them. I mean, I've studied fine art and I was left wanting, to be honest. I appreciate many forms of art, but I would say there's an element of work ethic that I respect a lot about comics. It's not necessarily in other crafts. There's other crafts that really just do any old bollocks will do. And the work I did in our college was more labor-esque. Yeah, I respond to that. But ultimately, it's storytelling. And you get to do a bit of everything in comics. You get to be a director, you get to be the cinematographer, you get to be, well, no, that's not true, I think the colorist is a cinematographer, but you get to light things, you get to cast it, you get to tell your own little epic. I hope that's a satisfactory answer. It's hard to answer those things sometimes because it's just like, it's just what I do. At this stage, it's just what I've always wanted. Also, when you get good at something, it certainly helps. Oh, good. When I get the script, do I sketch out the pages and show the writer, or do I just go after the sketch? Hesperus, I'm sure others have seen this before. Let's see if I can find a non-spoilery example. Okay, there we go. So this, I have a layout book. So when I get the script, I do it all out small like this. So if you've seen the 2-in-1 annual I did for Marvel this last year, I should say, you can see basically I've worked out all the storytelling. I'll work out where the speech bubbles are going to be, how the story flows. So I'll do it this size first, and then I will scan it. And I will, you know, fix it. You know, sometimes I'd redo things if they're not quite working. But I'll send that on to the editors, make sure it's approved, and then I will blow up the scans on Photoshop, and I will lightbox them onto the artboard. So that's my system. It's how I've done them for years and years, and I find it good because I can kind of just hunker down and concentrate on storytelling for a few days. And then come back and do the actual drawing. So at the moment, I'm working on a project, and I'm on issue 2 of it, and I've just done the layouts, so I've worked out all the storytelling and stuff. And I'm about to get down to the actual drawing of the actual project. Oh yeah, Hesperus is asking, saying they didn't realize how vital an editor is. A good editor is vital. They do so much behind the scenes work. Don't get me wrong, there's terrible editors that make life harder, but in my experience, I'm lucky to say I've generally worked with like just really good editors. Especially the ones who are like, you know, let you do your thing. Notes are fine, but it's nice knowing when an editor hires you to do what you do. And, you know, the stuff that you may not see me on for long is probably stuff where I wasn't necessarily getting to do that, and I would just go, eh, I'm good, I'm gonna go do something else. Yeah, I'm quite fortunate. I've had a lot of good experiences. Some bad, but they tend to be the exception, not the rule. Do you ever put up those story panels for sale? The from the sketchbook? No. They're just for me. They're also in a sketchbook. I'd have to rip them out, and there'd be something else in the back. Or anyone's wanted to buy them before anyway. I am thinking of doing a sketchbook, like print a sketchbook with a lot of them in it for books I've done over the years. I'd like to do that this year sometime if I could. Okay guys, I think this is done. This one went pretty fast. What time are we at? Just over an hour and a half. Not too bad. Batman always goes a little fast because I try this guy in my sleep. Yeah, I'm trying to think, is there any need to add any watercolor to this like I've done the last two, but I don't really think it needs it. Menace, it might annoy Marvel if I put them up. Put them up where? I'm not sure what you mean. Oh, thanks, Minsk. Yeah, the one last week that was a lot more complicated than this. There was no reference or anything because it's out of my head. It went a lot smoother. Alright, I think I'll be okay with the thumbnails. I mean, I post the thumbnails every about a week after any book I do comes out, I post the thumbnails on Twitter and on my newsletter. They are thumbnails, so I mean, you really can't make out the characters. You could just make out the storytelling. I think that'd be okay. But yeah, I'm going to look into trying to do that this year. Because I haven't really seen anybody else do it, and I think it would kind of be a little bit different. Tidying up some stray blacks here. Hi, Pistol Pearl. It would give this whole story away. That's why I never do it before an issue is out. I always do it after the issue is out. For like a week or 2 weeks. Yeah, never before. Oh, if I get a commission for story panel art, that would be... Well, they're layouts. They're just layouts, effectively. But, that would take way less time, I'll admit that. I sent out all the commissions that have been done so far. It's 2019 now, not 2018. I'm just going to... cover that up stylistically. Call this a day, so guys. Thanks for tuning in. I don't know what you're doing here. Like, tell your friends, or you know, or at least tune in next week because I will be doing another. No, actually, you know what? I don't think I will be doing one next week because a friend's visiting, so I won't be doing this next week. But I will the following week. I didn't realize I would probably be up to stuff on. I will be working next Monday. So check in. Yeah, I think I'll just have to skip it next week. So I can skip it out of work and everything. So yeah, the week after, check in. And I will be doing probably a Wolverine piece that week. Because that one's overdue. Do-do-do-do. There we go. Alright guys, thanks a million. I'll just show you up close how this looks. There you go. Thank you for tuning in, guys. Appreciate it. I'll catch you in a couple of weeks. Take it easy.